Good afternoon, student. For this session, here we're talking about a technique of costing. There are a lot of techniques of costing, like standard costing, job costing, unit costing, and marginal costing also. So, for the today's session, here we're talking about marginal costing. Marginal costing is the technique of costing. Now, what is the exact definition of a marginal costing? Marginal costing means what? Suppose here we're talking the example, through the example to understand this concept. My total manufacturing quantity, suppose that 100. And for a manufacturing each product, suppose 2 rupees is a cost of production. For each product, it means that my total cost of production will be 200. For 100 products, 200 rupees is a cost of production. Suppose management decided manufacture 99 products only. So cost of production will be remain same, that is 2. So 99 into 2 will be 198. Now, in the two example, in a first example, when quantity is 100 and manufacturing cost is 2, then that time cost of production will be 200. And in case of a 99 products unit, when we manufactured, when organization has to be taking decision to manufacture, then the cost, suppose that is 2 rupees, so cost will be 198. So by increasing one unit or by decreasing one unit, then whatever the effect on a cost of production, that effect is known as a marginal cost. In a first case, when production is 100 and then cost of production is 200, in a second case, when product is 99 and cost of production is 198, it means that by increasing 2 or by decreasing 2, this 2 is known as a marginal cost. So marginal cost is understood or recognized by the various countries with a different kind of the name. Marginal cost is also known as direct costing. Marginal cost is also known as contributory costing. Marginal cost is also known as incremental costing. Marginal cost is also known as contributory costing. So these are the different name of the marginal costing. In India, we say it's a marginal cost. Now, what are the features of marginal costing? The first feature is the most important, that is a marginal costing is a technique of costing. In the costing term, you know that the costing is based on two things. We find out the each product cost with the help of a method, either techniques. So marginal costing is a technique of costing. Marginal costing is essential for break-even analysis in an integrated important part of a marginal costing also. Marginal costing is the base on valuation of a stock of finished product and working progress also. Marginal costing is important for a fixed cost is recoverable from the contribution and the variable cost is charged to the production. The most important feature of marginal costing, so costs are classified on the basis of fixed and variable cost only. Semi-fixed prices are also converted either as a fixed cost or as a variable cost. So these are the some basic features of the marginal costing. Now, what are the exact advantages of marginal costing? With the help of marginal costing, definitely management has getting a very good benefit about the product information. The first important benefit is management can be understand the exact cost of production. Management can be understand the appropriate value of the production. Management can be understand at what price should be sell a product into the market. So that kind of the basic benefit definitely get through the marginal costing. So there are some list of the advantages of marginal costing. The first one is a constant in nature. In the marginal costing, this is the most important advantages of this part. The second thing is what? Realistic profit. Definitely, this is the most important benefit received through the marginal costing for every manufacturing organization. While the calculation of the marginal costing to get a every company's a realistic profit. Next benefit, simplified overhead treatment. Next one is a facilitate to the control. Then meaningful reporting. Now, meaningful reporting means what? Through the marginal costing, every organization has received the exact cost of production of organization, exact variable cost information, exact fixed cost information, exact profit amount. So these kind of the basic reporting information received through the marginal costing to the organization. A to the profit planning also. Definitely, through the marginal costing, company can be understand and company can be predict about the profit planning also. Because on the basis of the marginal costing, company has to be get the information about the exact profit company will be arise, exact profit company will be obtained about the selling of a goods. And the last thing is what? Break even point. Now break even point, you know that, understand. Break even point means a point at which there is no profit or no loss of the organization. So break even point analysis, information get in details to the every company through the marginal costing. So these are the some basic advantages of marginal costing. Now understanding of the marginal costing, should we understand the concept of a profit also? How to find out the profit? Dear student, profit is also known as a net margin. And how to understand the profit? This very simple formula for a calculation of the profit. Profit is equal to contribution minus fixed cost. Dear student, if you want to find out the profit of your respective sales, then you should be understand the some important things. You can see these things. Suppose that your sale is 10 rupees and your manufacturing cost, that is called the variable cost, is suppose that 5 rupees. So 10 rupees minus 5 rupees, then you will be get the 5 rupees contribution. Into the 5 rupees contribution, suppose the some fixed charges, for example, here the fixed charges is 2 rupees, it means that we'll get the 3 rupees benefit, yeah, 3 rupees profit from the selling. So when you organization fix the profit part, then organization should be understand sales minus variable cost, then contribution. Contribution minus fixed cost, then profit. So it is a very simple formula to find out the profit of every product. So sales minus variable cost, then contribution. Contribution minus fixed cost, then profit. So this is a simple calculation about the profit. Now, the second thing is the contribution. Dear student, contribution means nothing. It is the difference between selling price and variable cost. So it is known as a contribution. It is very simple formula to understand the contribution. So contribution is equal to fixed cost plus profit. Yeah, you can to understand contribution is equal to fixed cost minus loss. There is one more formula of a contribution. Contribution is equal to selling price minus variable cost, then that is called as a contribution. So contribution means nothing, that is a difference between your selling price and variable cost. Now, the second thing is what? PV ratio, that is called as a profit volume ratio. Dear student, so profit volume ratio is also known as a PV ratio. There are the different kind of the formulas to calculate the PV ratio. So what is the exact percentage of the profit? Organization can be easily find out through the PV ratio. So PV ratio, the first formula, PV ratio is equal to change in profit upon change in sales into the 100. Suppose if in the organization has to be part of a 2 years profit and 2 years sales, then that time to use this formula. Suppose if organization provide a sales and profit figures, sales and variable cost figures, then that time to use the second formula, that is a PV ratio is equal to contribution upon sales into 100. There is one more formula for the PV ratio is a fixed cost minus profit upon sales into 100. And there is one more formula to calculate the PV ratio. PV ratio is equal to 100 minus variable cost upon sales into 100. So these are the some basic formulas to calculate the percentage of a profit. Dear student, there is one more a short analysis. What is the exact effect of the PV ratio on a respective parts? See, the first part is a fixed cost. If increase the fixed cost, there is no effect on a PV ratio. If decrease the fixed cost, there is again no effect on a PV ratio. If increase the sales volume, there is no effect on a PV ratio. Yeah, if decrease the sales volume, there is no effect on a PV ratio. If increase the selling price, then definitely PV ratio will be increased. If decrease the selling price, then definitely PV ratio will be decreased. Dear student, for a variable cost is totally opposite, because if increase the variable cost, then definitely PV ratio will be decreased. And if decrease the PV variable cost, then that time your PV ratio will be increased. Why? Because of expenses, if increase, then profit will be down. If expenses will be down, then profit will be increased. So it's a simple analysis of a PV ratio. So through this part, here we understand the very simple technique of a costing, that is called as a marginal costing. So in the marginal costing, we understand here meaning of marginal costing, feature of marginal costing, advantages of marginal costing, and some basic concept like profit concept, contribution concept, and effect on a PV ratios. I hope you understand this concept. Thank you so much.